If you would rather avoid the exhausting expedition of deciphering 10 new features, surviving 15 changes, and tackling the 76 fix marathon just to separate the crucial from the trivial, well, welcome to the party. This video is your express ticket to saving time while we do the heavy lifting. So if you want an invite to the next party, be sure to whack the subscribe button, hit the bell. And of course, if you want us to keep doing these, tell us you like them, hit that like button, and we will get to it right after this. Think about what's making you afraid. There's nobody in the world who's ever wanted to fail, but a little bit of help can get you on your way. XABCD is where you can start today. Okay, feature number 2894. This is a big one. Indicator text will now be bold when selected. Okay, look, I'll be honest. At first, I was like, what's the deal with this one? Did they just toss it in because they had some spare coding energy? I mean, who's out there saying, I can't trade unless my indicator labels are bold? But hey, maybe there's some secret society of traders who swear by bold text for those epic trades. You never know, right? Or maybe they're just trying to tidy things up in the trading world. You know, bold and italics labels bring some style to the charts, you know? So embrace the bold, my fellow traders, and may your charts be as stylish as ever. Oh, may the bold be with you. Okay, before you get going, imagine this, right? You're heading to the beach. The first thing you do, you slather on sunscreen, right? Well, trading's kind of like that. We got the XABCD news tool, free, slick. It drops economic news events directly onto your chart. It keeps it neat and plays it smart, so you don't have to worry about frying the market. So over 4,000 savvy NTA users have it already. Why? Because who wants news post-meltdown? What would that do to your account? So get ahead with the XABCD news tool. You can get that at xabcdtrading.com. We'll put a link in the description as well. Feature 197. Okay, this one's really going to be shaking up the charting world by letting you send objects to the back or the front. Now, I could have sworn this was already in the platform. In fact, I'm 100% sure it was. You could hold your shift button and use your mouse wheel to send that indicator to the back and the front, which is handy because, you know, if you're using certain software that might draw an object over top of a candlestick, you can send that object behind the candlestick so you can still see it if you look at price action. Very useful. Now they've made it even more obvious, I guess. You can now right click on the indicator and say send it to the back or the front. So now everyone can play this little game of hide and seek with your indicators. Now this feature has our back and I guess our front now too. Feature 1642. So they've updated the compiler so that it uses C# features up to version 8. Now, for those of you who are not developers, this should mean a better increase in performance. Feature 4451, you will now notice an animated logo for NinjaTrader. Now, this might help with some slower machines that take longer to process a workspace or whatever, and it will let you know that NinjaTrader is still working where other people might have thought maybe it wasn't doing anything. There is an animated logo now for NinjaTrader, and you'll probably notice that as soon as you load it up. Feature 6579. So now you can customize your display properties of your contracts within the properties of NinjaTrader. So you can go in here and pick which one or which style you like to use. Feature 8753, they have updated Newtonsoft to version 13. Now this is actually meaningless to most of you. However, if you use certain indicators that use Newtonsoft, you will be required to do an update. So chances are your indicators might not work in that 8.1.2 and you'll have to get an update. We have ours available. So if you use our XABCD pattern software, install it after you install 8.1.2 and you will be able to get up and running. Fix 4658. So you won't believe the wild ride we've been on with this one. So here's the scoop. Our control center was doing some funky math, like trying to calculate some growth realized P&L. It was on a roller coaster. It was all over the place. So imagine this, you lose your connections, things kind of get chaotic. And when you're finally back online, your P&L looks like it took a detour through like the twilight zone. Now, no more math roller coaster rides for us in 8.1.2. Fix 4658 as your back. Make sure your P&L stays on that straight and narrow so your trading adventures can now be both profitable and drama-free. Fix 3435. Okay, this one is all about that trusty line drawing tool. Now picture this, you're trying to draw a line at a slick 45 degree angle. And what does it do? Okay, so it decides to put that second anchor point in a completely wrong location. So talk about a rebellious drawing tool. It's like trying to draw a straight line with a wobbly ruler, but 3.4, 3.5 in 8.1.2 has now stepped up to save that day. No more rogue anchor points ruining your charts. Now you can draw your lines with confidence, knowing that they will behave like they should. Fix 7.3.5.9. Now we talked a lot about before how to get forex.com data into NinjaTrader for free so that you can get FX data. This has actually not been able to happen with demo accounts. They were failing. I don't know if they were feeling a little bit camera shy, but they weren't connecting with demo accounts with forex.com before 8.1.2. So that fix has now happened. Fix 2.2.5.8. So this one is all about your trusty instruments. Now here's the story. Sometimes these instruments decide that they were to be on strike and refuse to roll over. Picture this, right? You're all set up to do some trading action Monday morning sort of thing, but your instruments are like, nah, not today. So they're basically giving you the cold shoulder. This fix, 2.2.5.8, has cracked that whip, figuratively, of course, and those instruments are now going to be back in line. So these instruments that were causing you problems before, trying to skip over their rollover duties, you know, go ahead, trade with confidence, know that your instruments are going to be ready to roll over, literally. Fix 3.4.3.7. Now this one is for non-US users who are using interactive brokers and didn't have data. They did not load. So you're ready to dive in for the trading week or whatever, and your data just refused to load. It's kind of like, well, how do you trade without data? But here's the good news, 3.4.3.7 has solved that issue. So if you ever had any issues with that, no more data loading woes for you. It's all fine now for those non-US users. Okay, fix 1.3.7.5 affects anyone that can't type in their password. Okay, this one's all about making sure, I thought it was funny, that after a series of incorrect login attempts, that you're not greeted with an error sign, even when you get your credentials right. So imagine this, you're juggling your passwords, usernames, whatever, a few mistypes, long fingernails, whatever it is that's causing you to not type in your password correctly. But wait, even once you get it right, you still get an error message that haunts you. There's good news, 1.3.7.5 will make sure that when you do type in your password correctly, after all those incorrect attempts, you're gonna actually be allowed in, so. Fix 2.9.8. Now, if you have a Hotmail account and you get your alerts sent to your email, you won't have an issue anymore. But before you did, right? Picture this, you're trying to get those alerts. They're pretty crucial to your trading sent over to your Hotmail, but it's just not cooperating. It's kind of like emails being trapped in some sort of a digital Bermuda Triangle. Okay. 2.9.8 has now fixed that. So now you won't have any more problems with your Hotmail account if you're using that for alerts, and you get those messages fired off rather quickly now with ease, knowing that they're actually going to be sent to you. So those Hotmail hiccups, those are gone. Fix 6.2.8.7. Now it seems that NinjaTrader has removed, I shouldn't say seems like, they did remove the shared service for Twitter and X, Twitter X. It's gone. It's like, I don't know, there's some reason they removed it. It's not entirely impossible. If you use something like that, you have to get custom coded to have your own share adapter. But the one that was shipped with NinjaTrader has now been removed in 8.1.2. So if you like this sort of video, please go to our website, xabcdtrading.com. In the footer, there's a spot for you to subscribe to our newsletter, which is maximum twice a month. So no more than that. And we keep you up to date on all this stuff, as well as updates, what happens after the updates, if there's anything that does come out hotfix wise, that sort of thing. But we also keep you updated on all our projects too, which is our free XABCD news indicator, download and used by over 4,000 NinjaTrader 8 users, as well as our free ATM pack, which is pretty close, about 3,000 NT8 users, and some cool paid products too, like our XABCD pattern suite, which is wildly popular. So trust us, it's all worthwhile. Check it out, xabcdtrading.com. And hey, before you go, please don't forget to show some love. Like this video you're watching right now and hit that subscribe button below and stay tuned for more awesome trading updates, as well as if you want to get that invite to that next party invitation for the next release. So we won't flood your inbox with our newsletter again twice a month if you want to keep up to date with that, but we will keep you informed right there so that if you need updates after this video, that's where you will find them. So what are you waiting for? Head to xabcdtrading.com today.